So we have a wonderful service this morning. And then, this midnight, God gave me a wonderful message to give you today. I was crying, I said, God, what shall I cry? God, what should I talk about today? And then I began to pray. I began to connect into the Spirit. And God gave me this message for you. With a text, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. And then I formulated my message. And I got the heading or the headline, Triggering Divine Healing. Triggering Divine Healing. Divine Healing. How do you trigger divine healing? All of us need healing from God. We want God to heal us, don't we? We expect God to heal our land. We expect God to heal us in so many ways of our life. How do we assess the healing of God? I think some says, I am the Lord that healed me. I am the Lord, your healer. I sent my word to heal your. Oh, I am the Lord, your healer. So if God is your healer, God is, it's true that God is your healer. But how does God, or how do we assess this healing power from God? God can heal our finances. God can heal our education. God can heal broken hearts. God can heal broken marriages. God can heal sicknesses. God can heal diseases. God can heal broken relationships and broken families. God is capable. God can heal anything and just anything. Because He is the mighty healer. Healer. What the group was. Are we singing?
Our subject today is
triggering divine healing. And as we move on, before this message comes to an end, God will heal you today.
Amen.
You will encounter a divine healing today.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14.
2 Chronicles 7, verse 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and forgive their sins, and will heal their life. Amen.
If my people, who are called out by my name, shall what? Shall humble themselves, and shall do what?
Shall pray.
Shall pray. And what again?
And seek my face.
And turn from their sins. I will forgive their sins and heal their land. That says the Almighty. This is what God is saying. God says, if my people, I want them to take it step by step. If my people, who are God's people, God is saying that if my own people, who are called out by my own name, they will humble themselves. And they will pray. Do we pray? And they will pray. And shall turn away from their sins. Then I, the Lord, I will forgive their sins. And I shall heal their land. That means that there's no sin that God cannot forgive. Isn't it? Please, don't let the enemy deceive you. Don't let Satan lie to you. Don't let your enemies lie to you. There's no sin that God will not forgive. But the only issue is, if only you can humble yourself and seek His face in prayer and turn from your sins, then you will hear a good news from God. May you hear a good news from God today.
Yeah.
Amen. So let's look at step by step. If my people, who are God's people? Why does God always say, my people? Why do God say, my people? And who are those people of God? Do you know, we are going to know who God's people are. When God called Moses out for the ministry of a lifetime to redeem Israelites from the Egyptian bondage, He used this phrase, my people, twice. God used my people twice. God took ownership of the people of Israel. Hallelujah. God took ownership of the people of Israel. So who are you? Please, you are the people of God. God has taken ownership of you. So you belong to God. Please know it. Have this knowledge. Always keep in mind that you are the people of God. You belong to God. God owns you. Your family demons do not own you. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God owns you. Your troubles do not own you. Your enemies do not own you. That's why somebody says, enemies are not
God.
Enemies are not God. Yes. So enemies are not God. Why are they not God? Because they don't own you. No matter what your enemies will do, they don't own you. Hallelujah. And they cannot do anything that would jeopardize with the gift and the destiny that God has made for you. Because you are God's own special people. God always says, my people, we are not a spiritual Israelite. So we are all the people of God. We belong to God. We are so precious. Amen. Now, in Exodus chapter 3, verse 7. We read this way. Exodus 3 verse 7 says, the Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying. I've heard them crying out because of their drivers and because of their slave drivers. And I am concerned about their. I am concerned about them. You hear from God? God is saying that He is concerned about you. Please, never think that God has forgotten about you. Never think that God is not caring. Never think that God does not care. Never think that God is not seeing your troubles. God is not seeing what is making you cry in your heart. God is not seeing what is making you bitter. Why are you so bitter? Why are you always crying? Why are you always lamenting? How about your God?
Understood the significance of the phrase, my people.
He did not want to meddle with the truth. He was careful to quote God in direct speech at Pharaoh, at Pharaoh's palace. Let's read Exodus 5 verse 1. Exodus 5 verse 1. When God says, my people, God, whenever God is talking, my people, Moses, my people, when Moses got to Pharaoh, he did not want to change the word of God. He did not want to do anything at all, with God's usage of my people. Because Moses understood the words of God saying, my people, my people, my people. Why is God calling my people? You are always God's people. When Moses got there, he said exactly, let's go read.
Exodus chapter 5 verse 1. And afterward, Moses and Aaron went in and told Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, let my people go, that they may hold a feast unto me in the wilderness.
You see, Moses quoted exactly what God said. Thus saith the Lord unto Pharaoh, let my people go. God is always jealous about his people. You don't know. Sometimes you say, when you don't know who you are in God, people mess you up. When you don't know who you are in life, you allow situations to get into your head, into your life, into your mind, and then you become discouraged. You cannot be discouraged when you know who your God is. When you know who you are before the Almighty. You are so precious that it cost God his only begotten Son. You are so precious that when the enemy, when Satan came to deceive you, to make you sin, and to make you fall short of the glory of God, when Satan came to make you sin, to be in order to be disconnected from the source, from the will and the love of God, God himself changed himself into a man. God himself. God came down from heaven. And he changed himself into a man to be born by a small girl, virgin born Mary, only to come and die to save you from your sins. You see what God can do? If it costs, if you can die, the Bible says, greater is a man, greater is a friend. That what? He lays down his life for his friend. Can you lay down your life for somebody? You cannot. But God did it. Jesus did it. Why? Because you are precious to him. God always wants you to be closer to him. God always wants you to enjoy some connection, some relationship with him. He wants to be with you. God wants to redeem you from your enemies. God wants to save you from your enemies. God wants to give you a better life, a better future. God wants to give you hope. When he says it's not possible, God says it is possible for you. God says I want to make it possible for you. That's a goal. You are too precious. You are too precious to forget God. God sees you so precious, so special. God sees you special than your fiance sees you. God sees you special than anybody sees you in this world. He sees you special. God sees you special than your mother. Hallelujah. God sees you special than your friend. Anybody who knows you, they cannot see you as special as how God sees you. You are special. God calls you my people. My people. Whenever you hear the word from the Bible, my people, my people, you're my people. God says, my people. What comes into your mind? How do I understand it? Don't live your life anywhere, anyhow. Don't believe things anyhow. Don't believe that God is no more God. Don't believe that miracles from God are ceased. Don't believe God. Don't believe that breakthroughs that comes from God is no more. It's not validated anymore. God is still running about his people. God is still working wonders for his people. And that God will work wonders in your life today. You are blessed. You are special. In Jesus' name. Amen. Something. Today, if we were to take out only one thing out of this verse that we just read, let it be this truth. God calls us my people. God calls us my people. So who are you? You are the people of who? God. Who are you? Say, I am the person of God. Who are you? You cannot say we are the people of who? God.